Good evening. I want to take a moment and welcome all of you to this Good Friday service. We're in the midst of the Triduum, some of the three holiest days of the church year, as we lead up to Easter. One of the things that the church tragically does sometimes is skips over the darkness and the challenge and the pain of Good Friday. So it's a wonderful testament to your faith that you're with us this evening. Before we begin, I want to make sure that you are aware that we have connection cards in the pew back in front of you. If you want to know more about our musical events at the Cathedral on an ongoing basis, you can fill one of these out and check on there that I'm interested in hearing more about music. You can give one of these to Tony or Donna after the service. Once again, thank you for joining us at St. John's, and thank you so much to Hayley and Tim for making this possible.
It's finished. We have judged God and condemned him to death. Enough of Jesus Christ. He bothers us. We have no king but Caesar, no law but gold and blood. Give him the cross. Do what you want, but just get rid of him. Take him away. It's too bad. It can't be helped. Let him be sacrificed and give us Barabbas. In a place called Gabbatha, Pilate holds court. "You have nothing to say?" asks Pilate. Jesus does not reply. "I find no evil in this man," says Pilate, "but put him to death if you insist. He's yours. Ecce homo." He stands there wearing his crown of thorns and draped in purple. For the last time, he looks at us. His eyes are full of tears and blood. "What can we do? He cannot stay here. Not with us a moment longer. He is a scandal for the Jews, and for us, nonsense." The sentence has been pronounced. It's written down according to the law in Greek, Hebrew, and Latin. And the crowd shouts for blood, and the judge washes his hands.
Thank you.
They give him back his clothes. They bring the cross. And Jesus welcomes it, the long-desired cross. And you, who truly seek, look, tremble in awe. For the first time, and for eternity, Jesus shoulders the cross, the consummation now and here of Eden's tree. Look, you who have stumbled, see what we can do. Each time we fail, over and over, we nail God to the cross. It's true, we suffer also. Our human misery is great. But what is there to say? He's there above us on the cross. The one who came not to explain, but to fulfill. Jesus receives the cross, and we the Holy Eucharist. As Jeremiah says, he gives us bread, we give him wood. The cross is large and long and difficult to handle. It's rigid, hard, and heavy. How long it takes to haul it step by step until one dies upon it. My Lord, do you have to drag this thing all by yourself? Then let me be patient with the wood that is your will for me to bear. For we must bear the cross before the cross bears us.
Thank you.
Company, march. And to all, victim and executioners, shuffle toward Calvary. Divinity, pulled by the neck, suddenly wavers and falls to earth. What have you got to say, my Lord, now that you know what it is like to fall, when your load tilts and sends you sprawling? How do you like this earth of yours? Not just the path of right is hard. The path of wrong is also treacherous, vertiginous. You can't just go, stone after stone. You have to find the way. Often we lose our footing, though the heart perseveres. Lord, by your holy knees, the knees that failed you both at once, the sudden nausea, the fall right at the start of that dread path, the clever trap, the earth you now discover. Keep us from falling for that first time, almost by accident.
Thank you.
Mothers, you who have seen your first, your only child expire. Think of the night, the last, beside the little one who lies there weeping. Recall the sip of water you wanted him to drink, the ice to break his fever, the death which comes little by little until you know it's there. Put on her tiny shoes. Give her fresh linen, for someone is coming to put her in the earth. Goodbye, my little one. Goodbye, flesh of my flesh. The fourth station is Mary's, who has accepted everything. There, on the corner of a street, she waits for him, the one who is the wealth of total poverty. She does not weep or speak. Her mouth is dry. Jesus draws near. She stands and watches him, and once again accepts it all. Her cry stifled deep in her heart. She does not speak. She looks at him. She is the church, and he is Jesus Christ, her Redeemer. Her soul strains to reach her son, like a dying soldier's cry. She stands there before God, her soul revealed. No part, no fiber of her heart holds back or refuses to accept. And just as God himself is there, she too is present. Accepts it all, and looks at him, the son conceived within her heart. She does not speak, but looks and looks at him, the Holy One. The moment comes when our life crumbles, when we cannot go on. It's then that we connect, that you permit us to help carry your cross. So Simon of Cyrene, strapped to his wood, stoutly embraces it and walks behind so that no fragment of the cross drags or is lost. All the disciples flee. Peter himself, in anger, denies his Lord. A woman pushes through the crowd into the thick of mockery and death. She reaches Jesus and takes his face in her hands. Teach us, Veronica, to brave human opinion. The one for whom Jesus is truth, not just a picture on the wall. That one is suspect, discomforts us. We do not understand her way of life, or what makes her act. Something in her escapes us and seems removed. A man who says his rosary, goes to confession openly, who fasts on Friday, is seen at Mass with women. He is ridiculous. He shocks. He irritates. He's strange. Let him be careful what he does, as we're watching him. His every move is evidence. Because the one who seeks in her imperfect way embodies Christ. Her face, the pale image of God, who lives scorned and triumphant in her heart. Once more, Veronica, show us the cloth. Show us the face you took into your hands on that last sacred journey. Show us the holy veil where you concealed the day of his intoxication, the vintner's face, fixing his image there forever, an image made of blood, his tears, our spit. It's not the stones along the way, or the reins suddenly pulled. It is the soul that falters. almost impulsively, and in mid-journey, we let go. The magnet has no pole, our faith no firmament. The way is long, the end too far, and we are all alone and unconsoled. How long time is. Deep in the soul, resentment brews against the yoke, against this brother cross. And we throw out our arms as in a dive and fall, no longer on our knees, but on our face. The body fails and the soul yields. Lord, spare us the second fall, that in our weariness we secretly desire.
Thank you.
before he climbs the hill for the last time. He lifts his hand and turns to those who follow. A few women in tears, their children in their arms. Look, look at him there, not just with a passing glance. Let's try to take him in. He's truly there, raising his hand, divinity itself. The one who bleeds for us, not just in paint and stone or on a wall. Why then, it's true. This man is God, Almighty God. And for our sake, he suffers there. What danger are we in? Why does he have to pay so great a price? Is it so easy, human salvation? The Son, to make it work, must tear himself out of his Father's heart. If paradise is painful, what about hell? Look how they treat Greenwood. What will they do with dead?
Thank you.
Once more, I've fallen. This time, it's finished. There's no way I can get up. I've been squeezed dry, like a used fruit. Humanity, this burden on my back, has grown too heavy. I've failed. I'm dead within. So die then. It is easier to lie flat on my belly than try and stand. Simpler to die than live. Beyond the cross, then lift the cross. Spare us, Lord, this third temptation, which is despair. Nothing is lost until death comes. I've finished with this wood, but not the nails. And Jesus falls for the third time, this time on Calvary, the summit.
Thank you.
Here on this level height, celestial wheat is threshed. The temple veil is torn, the Father naked. They have laid hands on God. Flesh of flesh begins to tremble, and the whole cosmos shakes, its entrails pierced. Let's lift our eyes and see. We've taken everything, his cloak, his robe. Nothing is sacred. They've stripped him bare, and he has nowhere to hide. He's there, revealed, defenseless, pure. So this is Jesus Christ. He looks ridiculous, all bruised and filthy. He smells of jail and psychiatric wards. You call him Christ, the Son of Man. This is no God. There is no Father up in heaven. All this kingdom stuff is bunk. He's sick up there, a charlatan. If he shuts up or blabbers on, who cares? They've taken everything, all but his scarlet blood. They've taken everything, all but his open wound. God is concealed. We hear our brother weep. My Lord, because you have been scorned, humiliated, shamed, pity the weak, the ones defeated by the strong, because they've left you with nothing. Pity all those in pain, the child in surgery for the third time, encouraged by the doctor, the wounded whose bandages are being changed, the humiliated spouse, the son beside his dying mother, and this fierce love that must be ripped out of our hearts.
Thank you.
God is no longer with us. He lies there on the earth like a trapped stag, and the pack has got him by the neck. My Lord, is it really you? You're here among us. They've pinned you to the ground. They press your knee against your heart. They twist his hand, the right hand of Almighty God. By his feet, they bind the Lamb, the always present one. Upon the cross, with chalk, they mark his height and girth. And when he feels the nails, we shall behold his face. Eternal Son, whose limit is infinity, here is the narrow place, the place with us you coveted. Here is Elijah with the widow's son. Here is the throne of David, of Solomon in all his glory. Here is our bed of love, cruel and powerful. It isn't easy getting a God to fit. You have to tug and wrench the body. It cracks and moans, stretched to the breaking point, as on the press and hideously quartered. The prophecy must be fulfilled. They pierced my hands and feet. They numbered all my bones. You're caught, my Lord. You can't escape. Your hands and feet are hammered to the cross. And I do not have to search, half-crazed, in all the firmament. The one who hangs, held by four nails, is all the God I need.
Thank you.
A while ago, he suffered. Now, he is going to die. And as he breathes, ever so slightly in the dark, the great cross sways. Everything's ready. The instrument will do its work. Inexorably, out of that place where God and human join, and soul and body have their source, the cross extracts and draws all his capacity for pain. He is alone, as Adam was alone in Eden. 3 hours, he is alone. Tastes our wine, the utter darkness of our lives when God withdraws. Our guest begins to feel his weight. His head droops. He cannot see his mother, and his father has abandoned him. He sips the cup and the slow poison of his death. Haven't you had enough, my Lord, of this sour wine? Where do you find the strength to lift your head and cry? You're thirsty, Lord. You're asking me. I'm all you need. With all my failures, I'm all you need, that all may be fulfilled.
Thank you.
Now, as the passion ends, compassion lives. No longer on the cross, Christ is with Mary, who takes him to her and accepts his consummation, as once she did the angel's promise. The one who suffered, exposed to all, again is hidden in his mother's breast. The church embraces her beloved, takes him forever in her care. What comes from God and from the mother, what man has done, is under her mantle now and kept with her forever. She takes him in. She sees. She touches him. She prays. She weeps. She wonders. She is the unguent and the cloth, the sepulcher and the myrrh. She is the priest, the altar and the urn, the upper room. Here ends the cross. The temple now begins.
Thank you.
the tomb where Christ is put after his suffering and death, the hole unsealed in haste, where he sleeps out his night until he wakes, the one whose side was pierced and rises to the Father. It's more than just a sepulcher. It is our flesh. It is humanity, your creature, whose depth is greater than the earth's. Now that his heart is open, now his hands are pierced, we bear no cross he does not fit, no sin his wounds won't heal. Come to us, Lord. Come from the altar where you hide. O Savior of the world, how deep your creature is, how open.